Hi, it's Mark from MicrosoftAccessExpert.com and WinningSolutionsInc.com, and today we're going to take a look at our Enhanced Customer Contact Database Template. Now, as the name Enhanced implies, we do have a just standard version of this template. So if the cost for this or it has a few too many features for you, you can check out the more basic version. So if you're viewing this on our at MicrosoftAccessExpert.com website, there's a link right on there to get to the standard version of this template. If you're visiting us and watching the video through our YouTube channel, there'll be a link in the notes below to get back to our website where you can check out more information and, most importantly, download a demo of this. And you'll definitely want to check out the demo before you purchase this template, because when you do purchase the template, you get the source code, which is everything the programmer used to make the database. And so by having that, it's kind of hard to return it. So you want to make absolutely sure this is going to be the right fit for you. So this database keeps track of contacts, as the name implies. It's designed to be incorporated into an existing Access database that you may have, or you could build a more powerful thing around it, or you can just use it the way it is. This version does have our calendar system embedded in it. The calendar function is available as a standalone template, which if you're looking to build something more freeform around that, that maybe has nothing to do with contacts, you'll want to check out our calendar database. It's very, very popular. So anyway, this has that in there for scheduling things related to your contacts. But again, if you just want to do more basic scheduling, non-contact related scheduling, probably just getting the calendar database separately is a better fit for you. And then we've got many other specialized versions for scheduling specific types of things built around the calendar database in other templates. So the way these are licensed is pretty cool. You're actually, when you purchase this, it doesn't matter whether you have five offices or 500 offices or two employees or 2,000 employees. It's just kind of one flat price. And it's pretty economical. So this is designed for people who do have some knowledge of Microsoft Access to be able to work with the database, make changes to it, and customize it to their needs. So when I demo this, if you see things in here that you don't need, you'll be able to take them out. Now, as I said, this does require some knowledge of Microsoft Access database creation to be able to do that. So if you don't have that knowledge, perhaps you know somebody who does, or you have someone in your organization who does who can help you out with that. But if that's not the case, we do provide that as a separate service. So you can contact us through our website, MicrosoftAccessExpert.com, by phone, email, chat with us over the web, many ways to contact us. And then we can give you a quote on customizing this database to suit a particular need, or if you have an Access database that you want it integrated in with, we can get you a quote on doing that integration for you. But you're not forced to use us. You can do the integration yourself or have someone else do it, because you've got the source code, so you're free to do what works best for you. Now, enough of that. Let's take a look at this database. So let's start with our maintain lists function. And so in here, you can basically maintain these different types of drop-down lists. So for example, one of these is the phone number type, and I'll show you this later when we get on a form where you fill in the phone number. So you can set all the different types that show up in the drop-down menu. If you have different employees that are involved with this, you can list those here. So you would actually put their name instead of just person one, person two, and you can just keep adding and adding and adding. There's quite a few that you can add, and as you can see, they can be color-coded. And then there's some control over how things open up in the calendar view. So very, very handy. If you want to designate locations for things, you're able to do that. So you just type the whatever you refer to your location one as in here. You could delete the other ones or add more, whatever you need to do. So pretty straightforward there. So let's head back to our main menu. And so I just need to click a couple buttons here. All right. Now we're back at our main menu. So the next thing a person would most likely want to do is add some new customers and contacts to their database. So you just click here to do that. Now, as you can see, we've got some tabs here, and I'll take you through the tabs. And as I had mentioned before, you have all those different phone number types to choose from, so you can get an idea of how that was controlled from the previous maintain list screen. And then you can store all types of information, whether it's a billing address and just all kinds of pertinent information about your customer or contact here. There's a tab here for putting freeform notes, so if you have a lot of specialized information you want to store, and this is a great place to do it. We also track call history, so you can keep track of when you last contacted this person and that sort of thing. There's an appointment history. You can add appointments. And again, that's where our calendar function comes in. So if you invoke that, that'll get you into the calendar system. And this even lets you do some basic tracking of payments. So that's kind of handy as well. So let's go ahead and close out of here. All right. Let's go to the view schedule by day list. So you can filter this many different ways. Especially if you have a lot of these types of things to look at. This helps you narrow them down, print them out, print summaries, things like that. Again, a very, very handy little function there. So now we're back at our main menu, and we can go ahead here and go to our view schedule calendar. Okay. This brings up our calendar view, which as you can see looks a lot like a Microsoft Outlook calendar, and that's not an accident because that's what everybody's familiar with. And you can double click on these things to bring them up. If you had a lot of things scheduled, they would display on here. You can switch the views to month and bi-weekly and week views, so all very, very handy. Obviously, if you're looking at a month view, there's going to be a limited amount of information that can be displayed in a square of this size, but that's why we offer the other views that allow you to look around and see what's going on there. You do have a setup where you can control things related to the calendar without doing any special programming, so that's kind of handy. So you can change start times and start days and nice things like that and how you view the calendar, so that's helpful as well. So anyway, let's head back here to our main menu. So all right, that's kind of the quick tour of this. Again, I'd encourage you to download the demo. If this doesn't do exactly what you want, there's a lot of options, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, for getting it to do exactly what you need to do. If you need a web or app version of this, we could custom program something like that for you. So don't hesitate to contact us about that if an Access solution isn't going to work for you. Access is a great solution for a lot of people because it is just quite a bit easier to program in than most other programming environments, especially if you've already done some Access database development before and just feel more comfortable working in it. You'll probably like this a lot. So thanks for watching the video. Have a great day.